What supplements should be taken by someone on PPIs?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Shane H. says, what sort of supplementation should someone on long-term use of PPIs consider? Well, I would first consider what you should do to get off the PPI. And so PPIs are targeting stomach acid. And so I would first and foremost be thinking of excess histamine might be leading to excess stomach acid. And I understand that the sphincter dysfunction can increase GERD without necessarily having higher stomach acid, but I also believe that high stomach acid can be a factor. Anecdotally, I certainly could see a connection between acid reflux and other symptoms of high histamine, including anxiety and itching. So I think that's very relevant for a lot of people. And so with histamine and stomach acid, I'm going to be thinking especially around methylation. And so all the methylation-related supplements could be relevant. I wouldn't as a shotgun approach just supplement with all methylation-related supplements, but I would look into dietary analysis and testing for methylation. As an intro to that, you might want to see Google Masterjohn Start Here for Methylation. Look at my Start Here for Methylation page. But you know, these are supplements like B12, choline, folate, and things like that. Other B vitamins and minerals are also relevant. And then I would be looking at other things that might help the sphincter dysfunction. And so anything pro-digestive might help. So like a Urban Moonshine Bitters cocktail might help just with stimulating digestion, taking a half an hour before your meals. Walking after the meal is probably very likely to help with acid reflux because so what happens is the acid sits on top of the pile of food in your stomach. And people with GERD have longer and taller clumps of acid. The acid coat on top of the food, it's bigger and bulkier in people with GERD. And mechanical stimulation of digestion will help mix it into the food. And so taking a walk after your meals can help with that. So if there's anything that you can do along those lines to reduce the dose or frequency or get rid of the PPIs, I think that would be ideal. You know, supplementing in compensation for the effects of the PPIs, protein, anything bound to proteins, which is going to be the bulk of the nutrients, but especially the B vitamins. You should probably try to eat a higher protein diet. Unless you're getting negative consequences from poor protein digestion, but if you're poorly digesting your protein, you are going to need more protein to nourish yourself. So I would think a higher protein diet and a multivitamin would really be the best things because there's too many nutrients whose absorption is going to be compromised by that. And then I don't really consider myself a gut specialist, but I would read up on what other people are, you know, who are specializing in the gut are saying about how to compensate for PPIs with the microbiome, because I would think that would also come into play. So I hope that helped, Shane. Thank you for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, You also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.